Namaskara. I'm Dr. Sunita Rana Agarwal and I'm from Dr. Agarwal Hospital's Bangalore. I'm an eye surgeon and I'm also medical genomics, and I'm going to talk to you about blinking. Now, this blink reflex, in 1857, and I read the book, which was written by McKenzie, said that you need to blink 25 times in 1 minute. However, by the time the 19th century came and we had the printing press, it dropped to 12 blinks in a minute. Over the last 20 years that I myself have been noticing, and if you notice any of your friends, if they are working on the computer, they may not even be blinking once in 1 minute. So what do we think is a normal blink reflex? I also had a patient come in with a 10-year-old child who was maybe blinking about 10 blinks a minute, which they thought was abnormal. And please believe me, I think that was normal. So where is that a problem? The problem is in our conception. The problem is in our realization. We cannot take it today for a person to blink more than 5 times in a minute. If they blink more than that, what we would like to say is that there has to be a cause behind it. Either the eye is too red, there is some irritation, there's a foreign body there. Some small amount of patients also have a tic that they would keep blinking. So when we want to treat this blinking, we need to first go to the causes of that blinking. If it was infection, allergy, foreign body, any of those conditions, we treat it with the required treatment. So we need steroids or antibiotics or non-steroidal anti-inflammatories or lubricant eye drops or artificial tears. Be that as it may, whatever way we try to treat them, the very, very small amount of patients who have got essential blinking problem, there we can only treat with gene therapy, which means we've tried them all and it's not going. So here, once again, we take a drop of blood, patient's own DNA, the patient's own fetal DNA, fetal stem cells, the injections to the patient. Slowly, slowly, this takes care of the situation.